Hello everyone! In this video we have, once again, its length is given 3, here is given 5, and these two angles are given as equal. The question is, what is the value of the x? Okay. We know that these two lines are parallel, right? So, if here is 2 alpha, that means here must be equal to alpha, right? And I want to represent one side of the square with y. Therefore, here is also y unit. So, if you focus on this triangle, for this triangle, if we apply tangent to alpha, tangent to alpha equal y over 3, right? Okay. We know that the expansion of tangent to alpha equal 2 times tangent alpha over 1 minus tangent squared alpha equal y over 3. Then, if you focus on this triangle, for this triangle, if you calculate tangent alpha equal 5 over y, right? So, let's plug in this value to the equation, 2 times 5 over y over 1 minus 5 over y whole squared equal y over 3. Right? Okay. Let's clear here. Therefore, 10 over y over 1 minus 25 over y squared equal y over 3. So 10 over y times y squared over y squared minus 25 equal y over 3. Right? If you simplify the expression, these are again, that means y squared minus 25 equal 30, y squared equal 55 units. Then, if you focus on this triangle, for this triangle, if you apply Pythagorean theorem, we get to the value of x, right? So, 3 squared plus y squared equal x squared, 9 plus y squared equal 55, equal x squared, so 64 equal x squared. Let's square root both sides of the equation. That means x is going to be 8 units. Okay. So that's the first method. Now we will calculate value of x using second method. If you notice that angle FBC is 90 minus 2 alpha, so here is 2 alpha, right? Okay. We know that these two sides are equal because of square. And if you focus on this triangle, if you move this triangle, bottom side of the square, like this. So here is alpha and this length is 5 units, right? Let's call here point K. Therefore, triangle BAE and triangle BCK are congruent, right? Okay. If you focus on this triangle, what's that? Here is 2 alpha. Here is 90 minus alpha. Right? 90 minus alpha. That means 90 minus alpha left here. Therefore, we get an isosceles triangle. So a triangle BFK is an isosceles triangle. So length of the BF must be equal to length of the KF. So X must be equal 8 units. So as the second method, now we will calculate the value of X using third method. This time, I want to represent one side of the square with M. So here must be equal M minus 5, right? And also here must be equal M minus 3. After that, if we draw a perpendicular line like this, if you notice that this triangle and this triangle have same angles, therefore these two triangles are congruent. So these two angles must be equal to each other. So if there's an M unit opposite side of this angle, opposite side of the same angle must be equal M unit. Likewise, if there's a 5 units opposite side of the alpha, opposite side of the alpha must be equal 5 units. Then, if you focus on this triangle, for this triangle, if you apply Pythagorean theorem, 3 squared plus M squared equal X squared. So X equal root 9 plus M squared, right? Okay. So if here is M, that means root 9 plus M squared minus M left here, right? Next step, if we connect these two points, note that this triangle and this triangle have same hypotenuse, right? Therefore, 5 squared plus root 9 plus m squared minus m whole squared must be equal m minus 5 whole squared plus m minus 3 whole squared. Therefore, 25 plus 9 plus m squared minus 2 times m times root 9 plus m squared equal m squared minus 10m plus 25 plus m squared minus 6m plus 9. Right? So these are again, and these are also again, right? So minus 2m root 9 plus m squared must be equal minus 16m. Right? Okay. If we divide both sides of the equation with minus 2m, let's simplify the expression. Here again. That means root 9 plus m squared equal 8. So if you square both sides of the equation, 9 plus m squared equal 64. That means m squared equal 55 units, right? Okay. For this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, m squared plus 9 equal x squared, you know that m squared equal 55, so x squared equal 64, that means x is going to be 8 minutes. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.